This first lesson is dedicated to the intro into trading rabbit logic. The goal of this lesson is to transform your idea, your thought, into the form that you would be able to put it into the AlgoWizard. First of all, we will define the conditional statement of the logic, then we will show you how it looks like in AlgoWizard. So, the logic goes like this. If previous candlestick closes above the simple moving average at period 200, then open the position. And if previous candlestick closes below the simple moving average at period 200, then close the position. Let me show you that in the graph. This red line is simple moving average. A simple moving average is the average of selected range of prices. In this case, of the last 200 candlesticks. So you can see the price going up and down, and the simple moving average is like flowing. And in this part, the simple moving average was decreasing. Let's assume that there, somewhere here, there was a downtrend. And at this point, it's getting back up. The simple moving average reflects it a little bit later, but it's increasing too. And here is the point where the price got above the simple moving average. And here is the point where the price got below the simple moving average. So at the graph, we saw these two conditions. If previous candlestick closes above the simple moving average at period 200, then open the position. And if previous candlestick closes below the simple moving average at period 200, then close the position. This is actually basic of everything. That's the logic that we are going to transform from idea to practice. And that's the goal of this workshop. Journey from your idea to the results of the backtest. We just want to teach you how to define it in the AlgoWizard. If we would take a look into the AlgoWizard, this is the default window. Here you can see the exact phrasing of our values. So the first one that we add into the long entry signal, because it's entry condition, bar closes above simple moving average 200. Bar, so candlestick, closes above simple moving average at period 200. And that's long entry signal. Then we have long exit signal. The second condition from the previous page of our slideshow here. Bar closes below simple moving average 200. So candlestick closes below simple moving average at period 200. You don't have to remember the exact phrasing because all these conditions are in the scroll bar right in the AlgoWizard. Because we wanted to make this workshop as practical as possible, we prepared results of strategy from AlgoWizard so you could see how it looks like. The strategy was tested on S&P 500 and 1 hour time frame. And that it look like this. What you can see here in the picture, indexes are growing up, and SMA, simple moving average, is in general a very good indicator of market growth. Now let's make things a little bit more difficult and see an example with two entry conditions. First of them is, if it's Thursday and it is 3 p.m., then open the trade. The second one is, if it is Friday and it is 3 p.m., then close the trade. So our conditions are Thursday and time is equal to 3 p.m. And here it's Friday and time is equal to 3 p.m. When it comes to all possible conditions, the point is to take them to elementary basic pieces and then put these pieces properly together. We want to apply all the conditions at the same time, so all the elements must be valid. In this case, it means Thursday 3 p.m. and Friday 3 p.m. This additional condition, in this case, and time, and is called operator. There are more of them, for example, or not. And this is how it looks in AlgoWizard. Again, this is the default basic template. And here we go. Bar day of week is equal to Thursday and our operator. Bar hour is equal to 3 p.m. And here, bar day of the week is equal to Friday, and bar hour is greater, but you can use is equal to 3 p.m. And our and here are so-called operators. This is the important thing, so please remember that one. And don't forget that if you want to put more conditions, you can string them and adding them in rows together with operators. You always click in this window to add another condition and you are adding them. And this is how such a strategy looks like in AlgoWizard. We did test it on gold on 1 hour time frame where it has a tendency to grow. And let's check trades in graph. You can see that the trades have the same intervals because they are open at the same time and they have the same length. Because the first condition was a time condition, when to open, and the second one was when to close, so also a time condition. Now let's move on a little bit and let's show how it looks like when you don't open the position immediately, but you put there a pending order. Also, the input conditions don't have to be indicators only, but also information, for example. So the condition goes like this. When no trade is opened and at the same time no trade was closed, then put pending order on price 1. In IT language, it's like this. If market positions count equals to 0 and no trade recently closed, then enter at stop on price 1. Now again, how it looks in AlgoWizard when we moved to the second bookmark now. So, if no trade recently closed and market position count is equal to 0, then enter at stop on price 1 and the price is defined here. And this strategy was generated right in Strategy Quant Builder, and this is its equity chart. And again, here we have the sample of the trade. Our pending order is constantly held in the market, and at this point the candlestick was long enough to intersect the price and open the trade. And here, the trade was profitably closed. And now, let's add something more. Now we know that if condition is valid, then action A is taken, and you can also see so-called else that works like this. If condition is met, take action A. If not, take the action B. This is just for you to know what it is when you will see it in AlgoWizard. Also, we talked about operator AND, where both conditions have to be met at once. Then we can use also OR operator, which says that at least one of the conditions must be valid. In practice, it would be, for example, Monday or Tuesday. It can be both days, but at least one of these days must be there. Now let's move on again and talk about how the robot works in time. The robot is not human. It has precisely a task which it follows and works in intervals. Very, very simply put. Here we have a graph, and the robot reacts to a concrete situation where it checks the predefined conditions and then it waits again. In this case, the robot reacts at the beginning of every candlestick and checks if the conditions are met. So, with every new candlestick in the chart, we ask if the entry condition is met, and if yes, so open the trade with predefined risk and profit. Or when the trade is already opened, then we ask, is the exit condition met? If so, close the trade. And as we said, the robot works in intervals and it reacts when so-called event happens. So when the candle is opened, the robot goes through all preset conditions, and if they are met, robot takes an action. And it is important to understand how the robot works. It's like when you play the piano, you have notes and then you play from sheet music. But in this case, you are the composer and the robot is the musician that follows your composition precisely. So, that was an introduction to the basic logic. We tried to make it as simple as possible for non-programmers. I guess it's still maybe a little bit more complicated now, but if you will follow this flow, in this workshop, you will get tools that will help you to convert your idea into working practice. And, you know, you will be able to make it work in strategy quant, make backtests, robustness tests, or even let the strategy quant generate strategies based on your ideas. And there is also one more thing. What does close a number in square bracket mean? Which candle is it? Because we will need to work with this information in the following lessons, we decided to explain it now. So how you can say which candle it is when there is a number in the square brackets? On daily time frame, close 1 is the closing price of yesterday. This is the current day, and the green line is price, and this candle is the previous day. And close 2 is this candle. What is a 1 hour time frame? Let's imagine that this is 1 hour time frame. Close 1 is the closing price of the previous hour. So this candle, this one would be second one. And very frequently asked question, what if there's 0? Well, 0 is simply the current price.